Yes, good evening, Jen. You are certainly right there. But as you mentioned, this day, it was always going to come. But I don't think that made it too much easier for Victorians today. They certainly would have known this day was coming. But I think the feeling was among them that when it became no hope, the season wasn't going to magically turn back up in the state. It certainly would have been a tough pill to swallow. I guess for Queensland, though, the saviours of the season do go the spoils. And it was announced today that the 2020 Grand Final will head to the Gabba. Can you believe ahead of round two, when Premier Anastasia Palaszczuk first stepped in, put her hand up to be a hub for the WA and SA team, she did flag, well, a Grand Final would be nice. It seemed fanciful then, but as this season's wind on, as the situation got worse in Victoria, these are unlikely allies, Rugby League Heartland and the AFL, their bond only got stronger to the point, well, it just was obvious this was the logical decision and the one that did come to reality today. Brace yourself, Melbourne. This is going to hurt.
So the 2020 Toyota AFL Grand Final, we played in Queensland at the Gabba.
Gillen in the Grand Final are going all the way with Palaszczuk.
We said in our pitch that we've got our own G here and it's called the Gabba. Queensland will absolutely do our best to put on a show as we host the grand final here at the Gabba.
From lockdown on the Gold Coast, Gillon McLachlan locked in an historic decider full of firsts. It'll take place at the Gabba on October 24, the first time it's ever gone outside Victoria. There'll be just 30,000 fans in attendance, COVID permitting, and the game will take place entirely under lights.
So we just need to finesse that with the broadcasters and others, but it's certainly, I don't think, any earlier than 5:30 up here, 6:30 Melbourne, and more likely later.
The AFL passed on bids from SA, WA and New South Wales, but since 2020's been full of surprises, Adelaide will be the backup plan.
It's not something that we're contemplating, Pete, but I think it's prudent of us to have, you know, I think it's incumbent upon us to have that backup plan.
For Queensland, this is reward from the AFL to its strongest ally in this crazy season. And in the spirit of seizing opportunity, they'll use it as a chance to grow the game.
We've nearly got 300,000 registered players up here now in Queensland. It's grown phenomenally in the last 10 years. We think we can double that in the next 10. And we think this will really help with the next push.
The Brownlow medal could go glove in hand with the grand final and also move up to Queensland. But at this stage, the league is yet to decide when and in what format this year's Night of Knights takes on.
In Queensland's bid, they offered to support the Brownlow, as did the Gold Coast City Council, which we're very, very appreciative of. We just need to think about how we do that and in what form we do it under COVID-safe plan.
The last time the grand final was somewhere other than the MCG was 1991. The pre-game entertainment at Waverley Park was Angry Anderson in a Batmobile. Queensland is promising better.
This is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity and we're not going to let anyone down.
Tim Morgan for 10 News First.